Good morning, my dear students. See, before this lecture, we discuss about the wool. Okay, this is the one type of natural fiber. How the wool we are getting? What is the process of wool? So today in this lecture, we are going to learn the next fiber, that is the silk fiber. Okay, you know that the silk is a type of natural fiber. And this is an animal fiber, means this silk we are getting from an animal, so it is known as an animal fiber. Okay, so first I will tell you about the silk. Okay, what is a silk? Silk is one fiber, okay, and it is first discovered in China. Okay, where it introduced first? It is first introduced in China, and then the second is in India. Okay, of India number is a second one. Okay, so silk is very strong fiber. Silk is very strong fiber and it has a natural shine. What? Silk is a strong fiber. Silk is strong fiber. This one point, and the second point is it has natural shine. Okay, it has a natural shine, and because of this the original silk when you will go to purchase, it is very costly. Why it is costly? Because it is a strong fiber, it is very soft fiber also, and it has a natural shine. Because of this characteristics of silk, it is very costly. Okay, now see whenever your mother purchase the sarees, okay, so different varieties of fibers are there, but the main important fiber, that is a silk, you just check also. Okay, this silk is a very costly fiber because it has a natural shine. Now how this silk fiber we are getting, what is the process, how we will get the silk clothes, so that all the points we are going to learn today. Okay, the next point is, that is, these all these points you write down in your notebook. Next point is sericulture. Next point is sericulture. Now sericulture means what? See, rearing of silkworm for obtaining silk fiber, that is known as a sericulture. Just read one time your textbook, in that the all information is given, means proper definition is given. Okay, sericulture means what? Rearing of silkworm to obtain a silk fiber. Now rearing means what? See, now we know that the silk fiber is very costly, so for the economic purpose, some persons, those are rear silkworm. Okay, means they are taking care of that. They rear a silkworm in a large amount, that known as a sericulture. And now this silk we are getting from a silkworm. This silkworm is important. Silkworm. Okay, now the next point, it is there, before to start the process how to get silkworm, we will see life cycle of silkworm. When female silk moth lay eggs on mulberry leaves. See here, mulberry is one plant. Okay, what happened when this female silk moth lays? It is one time female silk moth lay eggs made 200 to 500. See, at a time, how many eggs, see female silk moth lays 200 to 500. Okay, see here, here some example. Okay, after some times, what happened? These eggs hatch and larva, or you can say caterpillar, come out. Okay, the next stage is larva, caterpillar, or you can say it is a silk worm also. After the hatching process, it comes out and it start eating mulberry leaves for some times. Means this caterpillar start eating mulberry leaves. After that, the next step, that is a pupa. Now see, when this caterpillar eating a mulberry leaves, after that the next stage is what? Pupa. Means after eating, everything is completed, then these caterpillar or silkworm, it moves its head in a egg form. See, this is a egg. Okay, it moves a continuously head in this egg form, like this. Okay, and while this movement, it secrete protein, means it is a liquid form. Means how in our mouth automatically its saliva is there. Okay, it secrete, we secrete a saliva. The same way this silkworm secrete protein, it is in a liquid form, and when it come contact with air, it solidify. Okay, and then it form a fiber, means it like this, the cover it form around the pupa, means around that silkworm this cover is a form. Now who's this cover? What is this cover? This cover means when this silkworm secrete protein, that liquid, when it come contact with air, it solidify and it cover to the silkworm to protect itself. Okay, this process is happened because of to protect itself. Means this silkworm want to protect itself, because these stays, see, in 4th standard or in 3rd standard you learn the life cycle of butterfly. Okay, it for some days it is it is in a these stage. This stage is known as a pupa. Okay, what is this stage name? Is a pupa. After that, means this process is going on. This, it moves the head in the egg form. Okay, this process is going on, and when this process is completed, that is known as a cocoon. What? That is known as cocoon. See here, this diagram I drawn here, it is a cocoon, and inside this cocoon, adult silk moth is there. Okay, inside this cocoon, what? Adult silk moth. And after some times, it comes, this adult silk moth comes out, and again this process is continuously happening. Then again this female silk moth lay eggs here. See, at a time 200 to 500 eggs they can lay. Okay, but in this also, not all, see, some only the caterpillars, means silkworms, grows. Okay, so this is the life cycle of silk moth, how it this process is continuously going on. Okay, so here see, this pupa means now this outside the covering, that is only a silk fiber. Okay, that is known as a silk fiber. Now how to get the silk fiber, that we will learn in a next lecture. Thank you.